Now, this right here is a financial channel. I obviously talk about money, but behind the scenes, this is still a YouTube channel and there are videos that I actually need to edit. So for the most part, for the past 7 years or so, I have been using Adobe Premiere. Now, something crazy happened. I just switched over to DaVinci Resolve 18. And that's been the first time I switched programs in almost like a decade. And things are new, but I don't think I'm ever going to be going back to Adobe Premiere. And in this video, I'll tell you exactly why. Now, the first part is this, guys. Obviously, I'm a finance guy. I talk a lot about money. So financially, it just doesn't make any sense to actually have Adobe Premiere anymore. Now, here's the thing, okay? Sometimes we're actually able to get the same level of product with the same features and sometimes even better features for less money. And sometimes we don't even switch or consider the product just because the product we currently use for more money is more expensive, so we assume it must be better, and on top of that, it has a more well-known brand, so we also assume that it must be better overall. But when you actually stack up Adobe Premiere and DaVinci Resolve, you actually see the programs are not really that different overall. Everything I used to be able to do in Adobe Premiere, I'm actually able to actually do in DaVinci Resolve. Now, I do have to admit, there is one major drawback, and that's basically for every single person that ever has used, for example, an editing software, which is basically there is a little learning curve. I'll talk more about that later in the video. But here's the main con about Adobe Premiere these days is that basically everything now is a subscription model. Everything is about subscribing. You don't own anything. You're getting a license. You're having to pay every single month for the software. And usually, people that use Adobe Premiere, they usually have to use other programs like After Effects or even Photoshop, okay? I'm one of those guys, okay? So for the most part, you might be looking at paying every single month for the whole Adobe Cloud about $50. Now, if you are a student per se, well, you're actually able to get it for around like $20 to $30 or so, maybe $20 for the first year. So I was actually paying about $30 for the whole Adobe suite, okay, for the Adobe Cloud. And at the time, I was like, you know, it's not such a bad deal, but I really only use two programs, okay? I use Adobe Premiere and I use also Photoshop. So paying $30 every single month, multiplied by 12, that's going to be around $360. And at the time, I always thought that DaVinci Resolve was just an inferior product. Whenever I heard editing for free, I was just, it must be lousy. But then I started seeing on YouTube, a lot of people that I actually respect and I watch their content, they've been saying, I've been using DaVinci. I've actually switched from Final Cut Pro. I switched over from Premiere. And I was like, well, let me take a look at exactly the features this software actually has. Now, I gotta be honest, the main reason I actually downloaded DaVinci and actually gave it a chance, so if you got in value so far, I'm gonna ask for a favor, subscribe to the channel, because only like 20% of the people that watch are actually subscribed, so go ahead and subscribe right now because I have a lot more content. The main reason I actually downloaded DaVinci and actually gave it a chance was because I actually purchased this iPad Pro, okay? So when I actually purchased my iPad Pro and I said, you know what? I actually wanna do some editing here, okay? I was like, I wanna do some editing, but guess what? Premiere is not available here. We only have Rush. And I was like, well, that sucks. And I looked up, for example, what other software can I use for editing videos on my iPad? I got a recommendation for like a software cost like $30, but I was like, it's just not good enough. But then I actually saw, for example, DaVinci on here. And I was like, yo, I can actually get DaVinci Resolve on here and edit for free. And I gave it a chance. I started to edit my videos on my iPad. And I was like, yo, this software is just as good as Premiere. And if it runs this smooth per se, because this is an iPad, it is very limited, don't get me wrong. But if it runs like this on my iPad, it's probably gonna run 10 times better on my computer. And it did. I downloaded the free version, I tried it out, and I was like, it does everything I needed to do, and it's pretty much perfect. And I only have to pay $295, and that is basically it. That is a lot better than paying $30 a month for Adobe Premiere for eternity. I don't like that. And one of the best features on Adobe Premiere, which is basically the one I love right now, which is, hey, you can actually automate the captions. Well, I'm actually able to do that too when it comes to DaVinci Resolve. So you see the captions right here in this video, if you're actually seeing them, if you turn them on YouTube. Well, these are actually automatically generated, okay? I don't have to actually go in and type in and listen. No, it's automatically generated. I can do that either with Premiere or I can do it also with DaVinci Resolve. So why would I be paying every single month $30, $40, $50 when I can just buy a software for $295 and call it a day? Now, there is one more caveat here. You don't have to spend $295. There are deals that actually happen. If you go on eBay, you could actually buy a license for like around $150 to $200 potentially. And if you do get scammed, don't worry. eBay is potentially going to give you your money back, but I'm not vouching. I am not a lawyer, so keep that in mind. So buy at your own risk when it comes to eBay. And there are also deals where you can actually get, for example, like a little special keyboard for like $400 in total, and you actually save some money, which is pretty cool. And Black Friday is coming up pretty soon and Christmas, so there might be some deals popping up. But whenever I actually run the math, what I should have done from the very beginning was say, hey, I'm gonna download DaVinci Resolve, the free version, for an entire year. I'm going to use it, I'm gonna see how it works, and then after the year, I'm going to decide if I'm actually going to buy it. But all while actually waiting, I could have said, hey, it costs $300 for the subscription divided by 12. I got to save like $25 a month and then I can decide. That's basically it, okay? So I rather, for example, have, if you don't have like $295 right now to spend on the studio version, which by the way, I'll tell you why later in the video why you don't actually need it overall. But for the most part, if you do want to get the studio version, you're actually able to use a free version for a while, save up, and then buy the studio version and then call it a day. Because sometimes you don't have $300, but you do have an extra $20 or $50 you can actually spend every month, and that can actually get addictive. But it's better to save up and get the software and buy it and be done with it. Now, here is the truth about DaVinci Resolve, the free version, the studio version, and also, for example, Premiere Pro. Now, overall, what I noticed is that basically, you could actually get away with just using the free version for a very long time. One of the features you actually don't have in the free version is basically like to be able to isolate somebody's voice and cut out all the noise, which is actually pretty cool. But there are other ways you could actually do that, okay? And you don't have to spend that extra $295 to actually do it. And you do have, for example, some restrictions on the video quality you're actually able to edit on the free version. But unless you're actually editing like 36K footage and like 8K and like crazy footage, like crazy, you actually don't need to worry about those things. And every single feature that I actually love in Premiere, I'm actually able to find it in like DaVinci. Now, again, I say this again, there is a learning curve, like everything. The ways I used to actually do things in Premiere, from adding vignettes to my actual videos, where I actually just go into the color tab and just like scroll a little bit. Well, to do that in DaVinci is a little bit more different. The way you add blurs is a little bit more different. The way you do color correction is a little bit more different. The way you add graphics, you have to go into the Fusion tab sometimes, right? And then you actually have to go into the color tab to do the color grading. There is like, you know, all these tabs are like in Premiere, but for some reason, because I've been using Premiere for so long, it just felt like everything was just there for the most part, like in just one workspace. But DaVinci does a good job in just separating different workspaces by different categories, and then you're actually able to just go into one and focus in and lock into it. Now, here's how I actually crushed the learning curve. And by the way, I'm not saying I am as efficient as I am in Premiere with DaVinci, okay? Because it does take some time to actually get used to things, you know, like the inspector tab, you know, I did not understand that. I was like, yo, what is this, you know? But then it just kind of started making sense and it kind of became a lot more simple to actually understand. Now, for the most part, the way I actually crushed the learning curve was basically the same way I learned how to use Premiere. I didn't take a course on it. I just went on YouTube and I typed in every single question, okay? And this way I got answers and I basically got there a lot faster. Now, for the most part, one thing that actually helped me out a lot is when you actually go to customize your keyboard on DaVinci Resolve, you're actually able to pick out a Premiere layout. So this way, you know that you have Control K to actually cut, but now in DaVinci is like basically Control B. And sometimes it's kind of confusion, and to kind of zoom in, you have to do two things at the same time, like, you know, Control and then like the plus. Well, you know, in Premiere, you just click on the plus and it zooms in, minus it zooms out, Control K, and it kind of just like cuts the video. So a lot of those little shortcuts I'm actually just used to and actually just become like automatic for you because you use it so many times. I just went into the customized keyboard section and I switched it out back because I don't want to have to relearn those things over and over again because it's basically cemented in my brain. Now, I actually like DaVinci Resolve. I'm going to be using it for the long term, and that's basically about it. Premiere, I'm saying goodbye for now. Now, if Premiere does something crazy and it's just become such a great software, I might switch back, but for the most part, it doesn't make sense to pay somebody like over $300 every single like year to get something I'm actually able to get either for free with DaVinci Resolve or pay a one-time fee and get updates and everything else I need. And I've noticed that everything that Premiere is doing, DaVinci Resolve is keeping up with it, even if it's just one step behind with the AI stuff. And it's basically keeping up and basically adding features with the updates and everything else. And I feel pretty good about it, okay? So for now, DaVinci is where I'm staying. Now, here's my current setup, and I do want to address this. I still have, unfortunately, I actually still have Premiere. And here's why. Because I do use Photoshop, and I'm still using Photoshop to actually edit my thumbnails, I'm just so accustomed to it, I find myself that, well, if I'm gonna be paying for Photoshop, which is about like $20 a month, I'm actually just able to get right now like a trial on the Adobe Cloud for students, and you're actually able to get like $20 for the first year, then $30 for like the whole thing. I'm actually able to get the whole suite. So for right now, I still have Premiere. I'm still paying $20 per month, which kind of sucks, you know? But what I am gonna do is I'm looking into Affinity Photo 2, and I'm actually checking out tutorials and seeing how I can actually edit thumbnails on there. I'll probably do a trial, but using the software also, I can kind of replace my video editing with from Premiere to DaVinci and from Photoshop over to Affinity Photo and actually just learn how to do things. And these are all programs you're actually able to just pay a one-time fee. DaVinci, you can just use for free, like for the most part. But Affinity Photo, you have to pay about $70, and it's almost like a like for like of Photoshop, which I'm going to be trying out, so I can't give you like full detail on it, but when I am done with it, well, I'll tell you more about it. Again, this is a financial channel. So this is why I actually focus on the financial aspect when it comes to DaVinci and when it comes to Premiere. When you're paying for the Adobe name and everything else, and then you're paying $30 a month, and you're actually able to get that for less over somewhere else, I just prefer to go over there, even if there is a slight learning curve. All right, thanks for watching, guys. Like, subscribe, hit the bell so you get notified. This video is made possible by everyone on my Patreon. Here they are right here. Thank you for supporting. If you actually want to join us on Patreon, the link is going to be down below.